6 years ago, I had just finished my sophomore year in high school. It was the summertime, and I was about to enter my junior year in high school in a new state, new school, new everything, and I was very, very excited about it. It was my last couple of days in San Antonio, Texas for the time being, and I was on the phone with one of my good friends, Elizabeth Foreman. I was telling Lizzie all about my new bedroom and all the new things I was about to get into in my move to Virginia. As I was talking to Lizzie, I started to notice something about myself that I had never ever felt before. I started to feel this unusual sensation of not being able to remember what I was saying. It was as though there was a rain cloud forming inside of my brain and I could not get the sun to come back out. As hard as I tried, I could not get a complete sentence out of my mouth without pausing, saying, my brain was just not allowing me to complete full sentences. And inside, I started to panic because I had never in my life felt this before. And I had absolutely no control anymore over what I was thinking or what I was saying. Not having control in that moment was probably one of the most frightening moments I've ever felt in my life. And I did my very best in that moment not to relay it over the phone to Lizzie and just to try to calm myself down. Unfortunately, that did not work out too well because I had no idea what I was experiencing and what was about to happen. As I tried to get a hold of myself and finish my conversation with Lizzie, I lost even more control and I had my first ever seizure. This day was in the summer of 2010, and I will never forget it. I remember waking up and opening my eyes to cloudy vision on the floor, looking up at all of my family members who were staring down at me in complete panic and screaming my name. I will never forget the way that they screamed, Zoe. It still echoes through my brain. And anytime someone says my name the exact same way, it does make me feel very scared and anxious. Even if it's not in a bad situation, it just sends me off because this was the scariest moment of my life. I just could not keep my eyes open though. There was just an overwhelming feeling of needing to sleep, and so I allowed my eyes to shut again without any control over them, and I fell back asleep. The next time I opened my eyes, I was looking up in the same area of my bedroom, still laying on the floor, but this time there were EMT picking me up and putting me into an ambulance. I still distinctively remember the sound of the ambulance engine running. As the ambulance drove away, I started to cry out of confusion and looked up at my family. They're just as scared as I am, which makes me even more scared. We get to the hospital and it is confirmed that I just had a seizure. They did a bunch of scans and tests on me and were not able to locate the reasoning for my seizure. And that is how my seizures went from then on. After that first seizure, I started to have seizures every few months. I would have at least two. And finally, my senior year of high school, I was diagnosed with epilepsy. My seizures last anywhere from 30 seconds to 5 minutes. They happen the exact same way as my first one did. I can't focus on what I'm saying, and I pass out and have a seizure and wake up scared. The aftermath of my seizures is probably the worst part of having them. I usually always bite my tongue. I've almost bitten completely through my tongue, where I'm surprised I even still have one. Honestly, so I'm very thankful I never actually did that. I also don't know how to explain this feeling. After I had a seizure in the past, I feel this depression unlike any other I've felt my entire life. It's like all of the good feeling chemicals have just been sucked out of my body, and all I want to do is be near someone that I'm close with and to just not do anything at all. All I want to do is watch TV and absolutely do nothing else. I don't want to eat. I don't want to do anything, because all I feel is this overwhelming sense of depression. I just feel sad, and it's confusing because I have absolutely no reason to be sad, but it sucks and I can't change it, and unfortunately that is very common with people who have seizures, and it sucks. But yeah, so that is my seizure story. So the reason I'm telling you my seizure story is because this day, it's the end of May going into June, marks one entire year of me not having a single seizure. Yay! It's pretty freaking awesome. And This is the longest I have ever gone without having a seizure since my first seizure back in 2010. And I'm really proud of myself. I'm really proud of myself. I really did not want to cry. Holy crap, I did not see that coming. I am so happy that I have not had a seizure an entire year. This is the happiest. This is the happiest I've been in a very long time. I feel so much more in control of myself and how I feel. And I haven't felt this way in a very long time. So I'm very happy. And I'm not making this video for a pity party or for anyone to feel bad for me or anything like that. I'm making this video to just say that epilepsy does not control my life, and I do not define myself as epileptic or someone who has seizures. I really just wanted to make this video because I know that this definitely could help somebody out there, and to just let you know that you're not alone. Epilepsy and seizures suck, and if you ever see someone having one, just know it sucks and just be there for them and just be calm. I would never go back in time and change what happened to me. Seizures and epilepsy and all of that has made me a much stronger person today, and I take care of myself better than I have ever taken care of myself before in my life. It has really pushed me to love myself and take care of myself both physically and mentally in ways that I never would have imagined possible. Throughout my journey of epilepsy, I've noticed that more often than not, I will have a seizure if I am dehydrated, stressed, or have not gotten any sleep. And those are my three biggest triggers. And those are three things that you should never let enter your life. Get enough sleep, stay hydrated, drink lots of water. Don't let the little things get to you and stress you out to the point where you are putting yourself in danger. I've learned so, so, so much from this journey. And I am so thankful to be where I am today. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you're having an amazing day, an amazing week. I'm actually in the process of moving right now into a new place in Virginia Beach. It's all very exciting. I hope to see you all in my next video. Thank you so much, guys.